In today's video, I want to show you how you can create one of these abstract digital marbling pieces with the Procreate app on your iPad. If you are following me on Instagram, you will know that I love creating these, especially for relaxation and stress relief. But I've never actually made a video to show you the technique. This is what I'm going to do today, and so this is what you are going to learn today. All you need to follow along is an iPad and the Procreate app. You won't need an Apple Pencil or any special stylus. You could even do this just using your fingers. I'm using my Apple Pencil here because it makes it easier for you to see where I'm touching the screen. We're going to start by creating a new canvas, and I'm just going to select the screen size canvas for now. And then the brushes that I'm going to use today is my set of marbling brushes. It's got a wet marble brush, and then it's got a number of different texture brushes as well, and a glitter edge brush. And I'm going to show you how to use these brushes in this tutorial as well. To start with, we are going to use the wet marble brush. The brush set also comes with a color palette called Marble Colors. And we are going to start by selecting the deepest red color, and we are going to fill the layer. I always like working from the darkest color to the lightest color. So this red color is almost black. It's a very, very dark shade of burgundy. And then we're going to create a new layer, and we're going to change the color and choose the second lightest red here. And then with that wet marble brush set to about 26%, we're just going to draw in some streaks. This is quite random, so there's nothing fancy about this. And then we're going to select that liquify tool. So this is the magic when it comes to digital marbling on the iPad. You'll see that it's got a number of different options here to choose from, and we're going to be using some of them as part of this video, but the one to start with is going to be push. We're going to set the size at 39%, and then pressure, distortion, and momentum are all set to the max. And now this is where the fun start. So now what we're going to do is swirl the colors around on the screen, and I'm just going to start doing this a little bit so you can see what happens when we do that. So now it sort of starts creating these really, really cool patterns, and you can see how the color is kind of swirling around. And the way I'm thinking about this is almost like creating scrambled eggs. So you swirl the eggs around a little bit, and then you kind of push them in from the side. And so this is kind of how I describe this to myself. And you can already see now how this is starting to create different colors. Even though we've started with that red color, it's now started creating different shades of red by doing this. And this is exactly what we want. And then once you're happy with the first pass, we're going to change colors. We're going to select the lighter pink color now. And now one of the things you'll also notice is that I'm actually drawing on the same layer. Normally I recommend to create new layers, but for this technique you will need to continue painting on the same layer. We're going to keep the same brush, and so now we're going to draw in some highlights. And so now you're adding these highlights at different areas on your screen. And then we're going to go back to the liquify tool. And we don't have to change any settings. We can just carry on the way it was. And we're going to carry on with our scrambled egg making. So we're going to scramble a little bit and then push the colors around on the screen. And you can see now how they are mixing in with the colors we had before. And it creates this super, super nice marbling effect. So you're going to carry on doing this. And you know, there is no rush doing this. This is what is so relaxing about this technique. You don't have to rush it. You can just admire how the colors float around on the screen and how it creates these beautiful patterns. The nice thing, and maybe also the bad thing about this technique, is that you'll never create the same artwork twice. Every time you do this, it's a little bit different. And sometimes you make something beautiful and you want to recreate it, but because it's unique, it's really hard to do. But this is also what I really enjoy about this, is because every time I do this, I create something new, and sometimes even something that I didn't think was possible. So now we're just going to carry on scrambling this a little bit more and admiring the beautiful patterns that emerge by doing this. So now when you're doing this, you also want to make sure that you leave some of the dark areas as here, because this is creating a really nice contrast. So it's always nice to have the slightly lighter areas, but then also keep the dark areas. All right, so now we are going to carry on and we are going to choose white now as our next color. And we are going to create even more highlights here. And you can see this brush is really nice as well because it smudges and paints at the same time. So you can already start dragging the colors around a little bit while you are doing this and already start blending them a little bit. You can be quite generous with the white. I always like the milky texture this creates. All right, so now we're going to go back to the liquify tool. And we are going to carry on with our scrambling. Although this is maybe where we've added a little bit of cream to the eggs. I don't know whether you like adding cream to your eggs, but maybe this is what it would look like. And so now we can mix this up here as well. And so now you might ask, well, how do you know when you're finished with one of your layers? And it's actually really hard to determine. I usually carry on doing this until I'm bored, or I think, well, there's not much more that I want to change, or I'm just happy with what I'm seeing on the screen. It's very individual. I think you can do this for hours and hours, and sometimes I do. But then, you know, you might also get bored and you might like to try something else, and then it's fine to stop and try something else. This is the beauty of this. This is really for relaxation, for stress relief, and anything that helps with that is what you want to do next. All right, so now we have finished our base color. So now I want to show you some of the other tools here as well and how I use them, especially the expand and the pinch features here. So expand is really nice, especially if you have an area that you would like to make a little bit bigger. For example, here we've got this beautiful pattern, and if I wanted to exaggerate this a little bit, I can use my expand tool and just bring it out ever so slightly. So this creates a bit more of a ripple effect. If you don't like the ripple effect too much, you could also turn down distortion like this, and then it just expands without exaggerating your ripples. And then there might be an area where you might think, well, this is a bit too much color, or maybe a bit too much white. For example, here, you could also try the pinch tool, and then you do the same thing, except this time around, it sort of pinches the color in, and this helps reduce some of that white color that is here. And then you might like to increase this part. And so this is how you can even out your composition. Another tool that I quite like is the edge tool. This works a little bit similar to the pinch tool, but this is usually handy on the edges. If you wanted to narrow them a bit too much of one color, you could use the edge tool as well. So now I'm going to go back to push, and I'm just going to push these areas around just a little bit more and even them out and create this nice harmony between the different colors. As a next step, what I really like to do is use a color that's on the opposite wheel of the colors. So the last color we've used was this light pink, which is on this side of the color wheels. So now we're going to choose this light green color, and we are going to paint some more highlights here. And you can add as much or as little of this color that you want. This is completely up to you. I usually don't like going overboard with the complementary color too much. So just some little accents here and there will really add to your composition, but not make it too overpowering. So now we're going to go back to liquify. And as before, we're going to mix this in. And now we want to see how many other additional colors we create by mixing this. And it's looking really, really nice. I just want to spread the colors up here a little bit. And you can see this beautiful gradient. Who would have thought that this green and the pink really go nicely together? But as soon as you start creating the gradient and you mix it in with the other colors, it just creates this beautiful blend here. All right, so now this looks really nice, and you can see here there are even more options that you could try out as well, especially the twirl right and twirl left. These are super fun tools as well. I've just noticed this part here, and you can see now we can add some little twirls here, which is really cute. So you could use this on various parts here. But then another very cool tool that I like to use is actually the crystals, and so this creates little zigzag lines. This is quite cool as well. Just going to show you zigzags here just to make it a bit more irregular, and so this creates a really cool effect as well. But of course, if you would prefer your lines to be a little bit more straight, then you know you don't have to use this necessarily. I just wanted to show you. And then also definitely play with the size a little bit. So maybe this was a bit too small, but let's make it a bit bigger so we can make those zigzag lines a bit more intense. And you can see now this creates some more additional blend here as well. And then if you think this was maybe a bit too intense, you can go back to your push tool here. And then sometimes what I like to do is just try pushing the colors around a little bit and sort of even them out on the page. sort of going back to my scrambling egg movements and even move the sides in as well and even out some of the parts here like this. All right, I think it looks really good now. So now I'm gonna show you the next step, and this is now how we're gonna add a little bit more texture. So we're going to create a new layer and we're going to fill this layer with white. And this looks a bit scary now because we can't see our artwork, but bear with me, I'm gonna show you a super cool trick. So now we're gonna open the adjustments panel. We're gonna select a noise and then select layer. So now we're gonna add some noise to this. And you can leave the scale, octaves and turbulence exactly as they are, and you can leave the clouds as they are as well. And so now what we're going to do is drag to the left until you see noise here, say 60%. And then what we're going to do with the layer here is we're going to change this to color burn. So now you can see how it's got this noise on the screen. So I'm going to turn it off and I'm going to turn it back on. And this creates this super, super cool texture. So now the grain that we have looks really nice, but now I want to show you how we can take this a step further and how we can make these colors pop even more. So now we are going to add another new layer, and this time we are going to change the blend mode to overlay. You might already be familiar with this technique because I'm using it for my painting and for my lettering pieces as well. So really what we're doing here is setting the blend mode to overlay and then selecting that black color. So this is now where all our grain brushes are coming in handy. And to start with, I recommend that you start with that sandstorm grain brush. I've ordered these brushes in their order of intensity. So snow grain is that roughest grain, and then sandstorm is a little bit less, and all the way down to that very light grain brush. So depending on how much grain you would like to add to your painting, you can choose one of these settings. So I'm going to start with sandstorm, and I'm also going to make it a little bit smaller. And so now I'm going to go into these edges and I'm going to add a little bit more color here. Now this is only very subtle, so this might be quite hard to see, but I'm going to zoom out in a minute so that you can see what this looks like. So I'm pretty much just tracing the edges here of the red color. So now in all the parts where we have got some slightly darker edges, that's where I'm going to trace it. And then you can certainly take it into the other colors a little bit as well, especially here. So this looks quite nice. And then here as well, and it'll look very nice here because we already have this dark part, and then this is going to bring out the lighter part even more. And then here on these edges, we can even enhance them a little bit as well. And this is coming along really nicely, and you can see this is actually really easy to do as well. This, it doesn't take too long, but it's super satisfying because you can see the instant change, and you can see that you can create something beautiful. You don't even need any artistic talent. All you have to do is paint some colors in and scramble some pixels around the screen, and then you already feel like an artist. And then also what you can do as well, if you don't feel that this was the right brush, definitely feel free to try some of the other brushes. That just enough grain brush is really nice as well because it adds some slightly coarser grain. So you could add some of this over the top if you wanted to. I'm going to show you here so you can see this is quite a lot coarser than that sand grain. So maybe this was a bit too much, but you can add this here as well. All right, so now what we're going to do is the same thing, but for the highlights, we're going to add a new layer. And you can leave this layer in the normal blend mode. We don't need to change it, but now we're going to change the color to white, and we're going to go back to the sandstorm brush. And so now it's time to add some more highlights to our painting. And the way you want to do this is to look for a part where there is white already. So now we're going to enhance this and create a little bit more of a blend and create some more highlights. And it's coming along really, really nicely, but we can actually make it even nicer. So we're going to add another new layer, and now this is where our gold and silver colors come in. And for this artwork, I'm going to select gold, and I'm going to select the IPL glitter edge brush. I'm going to show you here where the lighter and the darker reds meet. So all we have to do now is draw this line. So this is not gold, it's almost like gold foil that we're going to add to the painting here. And this brush is pressure sensitive. So if you press hard, you can see it makes these really big splatters, and this is probably a bit too much. You don't want to press quite that hard. So, but now you can go in and you can add these golden lines where two colors meet. So between white and red, it's probably quite nice. But then definitely also add it to the green, for example, here. This is really nice. So the bigger the contrast, the nicer your gold separation will look. And again, you don't want to do this too often, otherwise it's not so special anymore. But don't be shy either. So you want to probably add 4 or 5 of these lines throughout the artwork, always following the line between the lighter and the darker parts. And now you can see how these golden accents really make a huge difference. And if you like the idea of gold, I want to show you another little trick which can make a huge difference as well. But this is really up to you. Sometimes it looks really nice, but sometimes it doesn't. So you might need to experiment a little bit. So now what we're going to do is go back to our original layer. And I encourage you to take a copy of this because we're going to add some more pixels onto this layer. So if you don't end up liking the result, you can go back to your previous version. So now we're just going to duplicate this layer. And then we're going to turn the visibility of this layer off. So this is now our spare copy, and we're going to paint on this layer. So now what we're going to do is actually drop in some golden color in different parts of your artwork. And so now all you have to do is drag the color swatch into the painting, and you can see now how it's filled this part with gold. And also you can see here, I'm still holding down my Apple pencil. You can see here that it says color drop threshold 20.8%. What this means is that you can determine how much of your artwork should get filled with the golden color. So if you drag it further right, you can see now it starts adding more gold. And then if you slide it further left, you can see how some of the gold is starting to drop off. And from personal experience, I felt that sort of around 20% is a nice setting. And so I'm just going to leave it like that. So this adds some really, really nice extra colors. But then now we've done it here, and now the whole painting feels a little bit unbalanced. So I think we need some more of that golden color down here as well. So now we're going to drag it down here. And now this has filled it quite a lot. So it might be that I've chosen the wrong swatch. So I'm gonna undo, and I'm gonna pick a different spot, and I'm gonna decrease my threshold. So now this looks better. So this is not too intense, which is what I like. And now we can add some more in some other spots as well. And again, sometimes it doesn't end up feeling the right shape that you've selected. So you can undo, and then you can try it again and also vary your color threshold. All right, and there you have it. This is how you can create a digital marbling piece on your iPad. You can find the brushes and also the color palette on my website. I'm gonna leave a link in the description of this video. I really hope you found this video useful. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And then I'm also going to put up another couple of videos with Procreate tutorials so you can get some more inspiration for the art that you can create on your iPad. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.